Zane 740 and Al Arbour.
Listen to Ted Nolan talking to Al Arbour as the game wound down. Some things haven't changed. Those were Ted Nolan's words. The only things changing, the win totals and the game's coach totals. Right now, Al is on the video board in a tape presentation.
That's how it all started.
Talking about his decision when to come to the Islanders
with Fred Shiro there. I was wondering how it is you don't age in some 34 years.
You mentioned it earlier in the broadcast. He had to be talked into coming to the Islanders, thinking that it was New York City.
Yep. Yep. Just turned the job down at first.
Yep.
And then Bill Torrey begged him to come out for a more direct first-hand look. Took him around Long Island and
called it a nice place for a Canadian family.
And it turned out to be home for a long, long time. Home now for Al is in Longboat Keys, Florida, during the winter, and they have a cottage. Al and his wife Claire up in Sudbury, Ontario, where they spent summer. But Long Island will always be home for Al Arbour and his family, and of course so many of the special people you see depicted here, including number 5. And Mike Bossy back in the Islanders organization. I'd like to have been Bill Torrey coaching or running that team and having to pay them in today's dollars with a salary cap. Oh, would never be able to keep them together.
Yeah, two words, not possible. Yeah.
They're chanting Arbour. If you get a good look at those eyes, they're going to be hard pressed to stay dry much longer.
Great buzz in this building before the game. Actually, the great buzz yesterday here at practices. The Islanders held practice at the Coliseum, and it just kept going all day today with Al at the morning skate addressing the team and then leading them on the
Crosby bench. Came back to pick it off.
Forever, and the party's just starting.
They sure did it right here. They did it right tonight.
This was as good as it gets.
Yep.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time we draw your attention to center ice, as Coach Ted Nolan will now escort Al Arbour to the area underneath Al's historic 739 banner that was raised to the rafters on January 25th, 1997.
What else impressed me? Al's had some real serious knee problems over the years, and he stayed standing on that bench or behind the bench the entirety of the game.
I'm told in the old days when he was coaching that he would smoke cigarettes in between periods, and you could tell what kind of game it was depending on how many butts there were there. But they were meticulously lined up half an inch apart. How many do you think he might have had tonight, huh?
This is his wife Claire.
Huge entourage, and his family came in from all over. We had a chance to meet a few of them this morning at morning skate.
Claire's brother and her son were here. Ted's enjoyed this almost as much as Al has.
There's no question about it, Howard. This meant an awful lot to have one of his coaching idols here. And not just here, but to be interacting with him. You know, he talked about, you know, how the elders in his community, in his native community, are so important. And he related that to Al Arbour and how he treats everybody. Now he looks up to him for advice, guidance, inspiration.
I believe they're chanting 740 again. Recognition of the exact number of games he's now won as an Islander coach, and all generations of Arbour enjoying a very special moment.
And in the honor of Al Arbour's historic achievement tonight, here to present Mr. Arbour with a framed Islanders jersey with the number 1500 on it, please welcome from the NHL Senior Executive Vice President of Business and Media, John Collins, and from the New York Islanders General Manager, Garth Snow, and Islanders owner, Charles Wong.
To wear that and see all four of those numbers, you know. It is easily the highest total of games coached in National Hockey League history by one coach with one team. Billy Ray of the Blackhawks, the only other one to have as many as 1,000.
To coach 1,500 games for one team. In honor of this historic occasion, we will now lower the 739 banner that has been in the rafters for the last 10 years.
Well, they are doing that tonight.
Here to receive the removal of the 739 banner, Islanders captain.
Why wait when you got a good thing going, right?
Milk it. Here's the deal now. 739 will come down, and they'll put one up which says 1500. And I believe 740 will go up later this year when they honor what they're calling the core of the four, meaning all of those who played for all four of the Stanley Cup championship teams. They'll be honored later this season. Bill Guerin and his two assistant captains, Brendan Witt and Mike Sillinger, are going to grab that 739 banner.
And Bill Guerin, Mike Sillinger, two of the three Islander players that actually played on teams against Al Arbour coached Islander teams. And all Bill Guerin said is, that means is I'm really getting old. Chris Simon is the other one, by the way.
You know what, though? This night makes everybody feel young again.
It sure does.
Because there's just something about Al Arbour behind that bench that looked right, even though it had been 13 years since he was last there. It didn't look like a gimmick. He didn't look out of context or out of place. It just looks right.
He had his notepad in his hand. He had it right there. He had a pen in his pocket. He had this. He had his position right behind the bench that fans had watched for, well, literally now 1,500 times, and it just seemed right. And the team did it so well. It didn't. You know, he was so afraid, Howie. I know you know, but he was so afraid that it was going to become. Not, you know, about him and not about the game, not about the team. It's become a circus. It's going to be media frenzy, whatever. You know what? They handled it right. He handled it right. And the team did it right by winning tonight, by coming back and winning it tonight.
Billy Guerin just said to him, this is going to look great in your basement, meaning the 739. I hope Al has at least a cathedral ceiling down there. And that 740 chant is
back
again.
And now entering the ice, please welcome some of Al Arbour's favorite hockey friends, Bill Torrey and the Islanders alumni. please welcome Mike Bossy. Eric Cairns. Clark Gillies. Richie Hansen.
Richie Hansen, a native Long Islander.
And Jerry Hart. Please welcome Benoit Hoag. Mike Hordy.
One that's going to say 1,500.
Pat LaFontaine. John Hockman. Steve Webb. They will now present Al Arbour with a brand new banner that will commemorate tonight's historic milestone.
Chant of Steve Webb is going up from fans who remember the more recent past. Thinking, but it'd be pretty good to find out. That's a pretty nice expression.
As the banner begins to get raised to the rafters, it's a nice sight.
Stoic, proud man such as Al Arbour, this tests every bit of resolve to hold his composure. This is about as emotional as it gets when you factor this whole weekend into the equation.
Had a chance to watch the game on Thursday night. Loved the way that the team competed.
Thought this time, the team. If the whole Islanders team
had a good day with the team yesterday.
Mr. Arbour and family.
A few meetings. Saw a lot of old friends in a news conference. And today was all about him and his day. Every family member that we had a chance to meet today, we met many of them, said you have no idea how much this means to him. And what they probably don't understand is how much it means to all of the Islander people to have him back.
See, they're all gathering together now for what's going to be one big group picture. Jean Potvin and Al had a very close relationship, so much so that when Jean was traded by the Islanders to the Cleveland Barons, Al and Jean cried about it together. That's how close they were. Eventually, Jean came back to the Islanders. Organization has had so many memorable postseason moments and won so many memorable regular season games, but the entire package of Al Arbour's 1,500th Islanders game coached has also produced memories that will last a long, long time. Ted Nolan understands every bit of it. It's quite a legacy Al left. The whole Islander organization needs to be commended tonight because you can't put it together any better than they
did. No, they did it right. They did it absolutely right as it goes up to the rafters after the group picture. They pulled it off without a hitch, without it becoming a circus-like atmosphere. It was the game first, and let's not look past that. I mean, how about the comeback by the New York Islanders down 2-0 to a very good Pittsburgh Penguin team? I think he's equally as proud. I guarantee he'll say I'm equally as proud about tonight's victory as I am my 1,500th game here.
Well, his one-day contract is up, which makes him a free agent.
Sign him. If A-Rod wants $350 million, sign him to that money. This guy has such presence about him.
See the colorful streamers, which just began to cascade down from the rafters here at the Coliseum, surrounding the newest banner to be raised.
This is not just one of the greatest coaches in the NHL. He's one of the greatest coaches in team sports history.
Well, let's put it this way. If the Islanders enjoyed the profile that the New York Yankees do, Al Arbour would be just 40 times.
Let's hear it one more time. For Mr. 1500, a member of the Hockey Hall of Fame, a member of the Islanders Hall of Fame, head coach Al Arbour.
Jovi and Jennifer Nettles' words are.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the Islanders family, thank you for being part of this very special occasion here at the Nassau Coliseum tonight. We thank you for your continued support as Islanders fans.
What a night for Islanders fans, huh? What a night.
What a night for Alger Joseph Arbour. 1,500 games coached with the Islanders, 740. Games won as an Islander coach. He was inducted into the Hockey Hall of Fame 10 years ago. And I wonder if he had any idea that he'd be able to add to that total some 10 years later. Al is standing by.
The New York Islanders, thank you for attending.
Going to be downstairs in just a moment with Deb Dolphin.